do this every couple weeks. We take care of business for once. And joining us this morning, we have Deb Eckelberger from the Titusville Community Development Agencies. Rob Kerr from the Titusville Dairy. Good morning, guys. How are you this morning? Welcome to the program. And Deb, before we really introduce Ralph, tell us about this week and how you arrived at the Titusville Dairy.
Well, it's one of those unique businesses that we are trying to highlight through this program and let people know the great things that go on here in Titusville. And it's always tops on my list. I buy cottage cheese from there on a regular basis or drag it to all my friends and family because they all ask for it once they have some of mine. So we just thought it would be a great thing to highlight. No, again, another business that no one knows really exists here, but does a great job. So we're happy to showcase them today.
Yeah. Well, Ralph, let's start with you. Tell us a little bit about yourself before we get into the business.
I'm from Titusville. I was born and raised in a dairy farm just north of town. Graduated from Titusville High School. Started at the dairy in 1982, I believe. Was there for quite a while and took a 7-year hiatus and worked for the Pennsylvania Department of Agriculture.
Wow.
And then I came back in 2003 and been there ever since.
That's great. So dairy's in your blood.
Yeah, we bleed white.
Well, what sort of things growing up on a farm did you have to do?
Well, we had a dairy farm. We milked about, I think, about 84 head of cows. So raised our own crops. It was a family farm. My grandfather's, my father's, my brother and I worked together for a while.
That's amazing. Do you see any of that still exists today? We talk about agriculture quite a bit and how important it is in Pennsylvania, but do people really understand how important it is?
No, I don't think so. And actually, a lot of the small farms are going away. We're moving more into farm factories, larger farms, more automation. They even have robotic milkers now out there that just take care of just about everything.
Wow.
Pennsylvania's unique. We do still have quite a few small farms. Just gets harder and harder every year.
That was one of the things that folks mentioned on Tuesday. Titusville Rotary here had their Farm City Day, and one of the things that got mentioned was that most of the farms, not all of them, but most of the farms average about 69, 70 head of cattle.
Mm-hmm.
And that's pretty interesting stuff. So but you're right, it gets harder for those folks every year.
It's just funny, it even leaks into sporting events, you know, especially like football. You know, when you're going down to Mercer County and you're playing, you know, a certain school, there are a bunch of farm kids and they're built and they're tough. We're sort of missing that, aren't we, today?
Yeah, that was when I was in high school, we got to skip a little bit of that because we worked out every day.
Yeah.
I've since quit.
Well, you look good. You look good. But no, but you guys were, I mean, you'd be getting up in the morning. I mean, you'd be doing manual labor when you're not in school. So there was a lot of work at home. Mm-hmm. A lot of responsibility, too.
Yep. It's a lifestyle. I mean, it really is. Some days I actually miss it.
Oh, I'm sure.
Working with your hands.
Yeah.
Yeah, that part of it. Yeah.
Well, I think there's something that's amazing. You know, when you actually use your hands and you're in the ground, you're planting something, or, you know, when you can actually see that corn grow or, you know, the crop or whatever it is, or somebody's drinking milk that you had a hand in, that I think is a pretty amazing thing.
Mm-hmm. It is.
Hope you washed your hands.
I'll be right back. So let's talk about the dairy then. How long has the dairy been around?
This is actually our 90th year.
Oh, that's great.
They opened for business in September of 1926.
And there's actually a pretty long, detailed history about all that.
Yeah, there is. It's actually started out as a co-op. A group of farms got together, and they hired a gentleman by the name of Herman Raybild from Denmark. And he ran the plant for quite a few years. And it went through some transitions in the mid-70s, was bought up by a group of dairies, which two of them still own part of Titusville Dairy. Marburger Dairy in Evans City, PA owns part of the dairy. Turner Dairy in Penn Hills. And then Bruce Reed, who started Brewster's franchises.
Really?
Of Brewster's Real Ice Cream. So it's a diverse group, but...
Does that make things difficult locally when you're trying to conduct business?
No, not really. I mean, it's kind of different that Marburgers and Turners are actually competitors, so to speak. But when we get together for Titusville Dairy, it's all about Titusville Dairy. And their families are very supportive. They're both family-owned dairies. Probably see some of each of their products here in town. They deliver in town and surrounding areas. but great people. And Brewster's, we have a new one up in Erie again now.
Oh, good.
Yeah.
My wife absolutely loves Brewster's.
There's one in Butler I go to, yeah.
Well, we go to the one in Hermitage.
Mm-hmm. Yep. And I think they've got, they're 200-plus franchises now, and we supply all their ice cream mix.
So it sounds like, I mean, you're talking about some larger companies here. In today's world, we hear about smaller businesses being shut down to save money or to do whatever. Why keep Titusville? What's going on here that's so special?
Well, we kind of specialize in byproducts of milk, you know. So cottage cheese and ice cream mix are our two biggest products. We made about 3.5 million pounds of cottage cheese last year. And about 1.4 million gallons of ice cream mix. We do a lot of private labeling. Cottage cheese, there's not a lot of cottage cheese plants left. I think we're the only grade A cottage cheese plant left in Pennsylvania.
Really?
Now, New York State, there's a couple big cheese plants. And in the scheme of things, we're actually very small. But we private label for Marburgers, Turner's, Mung, Schneider's, Dairyman's over in Cleveland, two other labels in Cleveland. Most of our cheese, except a few 5-pound tubs, has somebody else's label on it. So
talk about the ice cream mix. I mean, because it's hard to imagine any of the ice cream places around this area not carrying a product from Titusville Dairy.
We have about 80 independent stops that we personally take care of, mostly within a 100-mile radius. We get up into Buffalo, down towards Pittsburgh, across the line into Ohio and into New York. Then Marburgers and Turner's also distribute our mix, and it's under our label. And then Brewster's, it's all up and down the East Coast. We ship to Georgia, Florida, Virginia, Michigan, believe it or not, South America, Guyana.
Really?
Wow.
And I think the first shipment just headed for South Korea.
Wow.
That's really amazing.
And those are Brewster's franchises that are going worldwide.
International.
Yeah, international.
Well, that's a benefit, is they get to carry your product with them.
Yeah, it is. It's a logistic nightmare that we're not involved in, thank goodness. So it gets picked up at our dock, and that's the last we see of it.
So your drivers then, and Mark was commenting earlier that, you know, we're neighbors to you guys. It's great on the way to work. It's busy down there, and you're talking 4 or 5 in the morning, things are happening. When we're leaving, things are happening. So your drivers, when do they start? When are they getting back? How far are they going?
They usually start fairly early in the morning and are done mid to late afternoon. A lot busier in the summer with our independent ice cream stands that we deliver. We have a few stands that stay open all winter that we have to take care of in the winter, obviously. But most, the bulk of our stuff is actually run to another dairy or another distributor and distributed from there. The 80, yeah, I'd say around 80 independent stands we do.
Oh, that's amazing. And now, can anybody come in and buy anything? Or is it pretty much just a distribution center?
No, we do sell quite a bit of product right there at the dairy. People come up to the office and buy cottage cheese, sour cream, chip dip. Those are all products we make. We make yogurt, also only yogurt in 5-pound tubs, no small cup. We bottle some water and bottle some tea. Pretty diverse, kind of what nobody else wants to do, we do for them. And that's kind of how we stayed there. You know, we have the niche with the ice cream mix and the cottage cheese.
So do they call you guys directly, or are they calling somebody else to figure out, hey, can you guys do water? Can you do yogurt? Can you do...
Most of the water we bottle actually goes to our owner. We private label for them, just like the cottage cheese. Our independent stands, we call them twice a week to get their orders from them. The rest of the orders are either faxed in or emailed in, and we fill them and ship out to them.
We just got word on Tuesday that it's going to be an early spring. When do you guys start shipping the mixes to the stands?
That's a good thing. Actually, weather is a big factor in ice cream mix. That can make or break your season. You get a nice day in March for the ones that are open, that could be the best day of the year. You know, even better than June, July, or August. Because everybody's waiting, can't wait to get to their favorite ice cream store, and you get some sunshine, and everybody takes off.
Right. Well, everybody wants that first sign of spring, or that, you know, that first sign that summer's around the corner, and it's usually ice cream.
Yep. Yeah, actually, production was up a little bit this week for what we shipped to Georgia and Florida. We're sending a couple trailer loads down Friday.
Wow, that's fantastic. So when do you guys typically start? Are you looking at end of February, March?
Yeah, before? Our mixed season's mid to late March to September, October. Kind of when fairs start, schools start, the mixed season kind of starts dropping off.
90 years in business, that's very exciting. What's ahead in the future for you guys?
Our owners are very proactive. We've put some money back in the plant. We just purchased having built a new, we still put mix in paper gallons. We have a new paper gallon filler coming. We just did some floor work over there. As far as their families are concerned, they have a deep love for Titusville Dairy and the products, and as long as we keep making quality products at a reasonable price, I would assume we'd be here.
At least till retirement, right?
Yeah,
I don't see you retiring, though. It sounds like, I mean, again, you grew up with dairy in your blood. You're at the Titusville Dairy. I see you somehow involved.
Yeah, it's a little scary. You talk to a lot of dairy people, and they work late into their years, you know. It's the dairy, much like the farm, is a way of life also. In the old days, you used to come to work in the dark and leave in the dark. We worked hard, long hours, and we've gotten more efficient and better at it now. But it's still, I always tell a new employee, I can tell you when you're coming to work, but I can never tell you when you're going to go home.
I know people like that.
It is 20 minutes past the hour of 8 o'clock. We're taking care of business with Ralph Kerr and the Titusville Dairy. This is the Morning Drill on Stream Television and the Allegheny News Talk Sports Network. So you talk about growing up in again, having dairy in your blood. How much of that has helped you in this business?
Oh, well, it all helps because you see all sides of it. We do purchase raw milk, obviously, from not directly from the farms, but mostly local farms. Most of our milk is shippers that ship to Marburger Dairy, and they just divert the milk to us. I think last year we received about 23 million pounds of raw milk to be processed into other products.
That's a lot of milk.
That is a lot of milk.
Yeah, and it sounds like, I mean, but we're very small. I mean, if you talk to some of the other dairies, you know, especially fluid milk, you know, they're processing a lot more than that.
You know, you hear a lot today, and it seems like every other day there's a story, coffee's good, coffee's bad, milk is good, milk is bad. Do those stories change the way business is done here? Do you see ups and downs in the product you sell?
Oh, yeah. All natural has become a big thing. Organic's become a big thing. I'm on the public radio, so I won't express my opinions on that. But, yeah, it does. And trends, you know, low carb. We made low carb ice cream for a while, and, you know, it just went away. It's kind of funny. In our world, higher fat ice cream mix now is more prevalent in the lower fats. More of a premium, you know, we make about 23 different mixes, you know, different fat levels, different solid levels and stuff like that, and for different purposes, to be made into hard ice cream or drawn out of a soft serve machine. But the higher fat seems to have stuck around for a while, which is kind of odd. But if you want, I guess people, if they want to treat, they want to indulge, they want to be a good indulgence.
Yeah, if you're gonna take
the step,
yeah, that's right.
Do it all the way.
Yeah.
I just think it's neat that you have such a history. 90 years, I mean, that's part and parcel of what Titusville is. People, that's four or five generations of people that have grown up with this dairy here in town. I don't imagine there's a lot of people that can think that Titusville would be without something like that.
Yeah, it's kind of, we're kind of like the best kept secret. I mean, we're right down there behind the Y, the old Y, and a lot of people don't know we're even there. And like I said, you don't see our name on a lot of products. You may see our product at Walmart or at Giant Eagle, but it has somebody else's name on it.
Yeah, or in the summer, you're spending a lot of time eating.
Right, but you never see the package.
Right. And by the way, I give a lot of credit to those stands who actually put the Titusville Dairy product logo sign in their window.
Yeah.
I look for it. Every time I get a little ice cream stand, I look to see. Yeah.
How many people are employed at the dairy?
26 full-time. And then in the summer, we usually hire some seasonable people to help get us through ice cream mix season and vacations and stuff.
Do you welcome folks coming in to fill out applications just in case something opens up?
Yeah, I have a drawer full now.
Yeah.
Yeah. And it's a nice summer job. A lot of employees' children have also grown up there in the summer, you know. So
family atmosphere.
Yeah.
It is, yes.
And I guess the jobs there vary. Talk about some of the things that people are doing within the dairy without giving away the trade secrets.
Oh, okay. As far as cottage cheese goes, it actually takes about 13 hours to make the curd. So usually if you see the lights on at night over there, we're making curd for cottage cheese. We have a cheese maker, and then we have three fellas that come in the morning and dress the cheese, put the dressing on the cheese, and then package it. We receive, of course, one department's receiving and processing, where we receive milk and pasteurize it to be used for whatever. The mix room, where we make mix and package it. And then over on the other side of the plant, we do a lot of packaging of mix, and we bottle some water and private label some iced tea.
So a couple people here, a couple people there,
yeah,
they're all
yeah.
playing a big part in making the day-to-day operations go.
Smoothly, supposedly.
Supposedly.
Yeah. Yeah, that's right.
I know you're kind of anxious to get back over there to see what's going
Can't
on.
Can't wait.
When you're at an ice cream stand, is there a certain flavor you have to have?
Me personally?
Yeah, or do you like to test a little bit of everything?
Yeah, I like to explore, you know. If you go to a soft serve stand, if it's vanilla or chocolate, it's usually just our mix. If they have a flavor, then they've added a flavor to it. Hard ice cream that's made with our mix, you know, obviously we just make the base. They add all the inclusions, swirl in whatever, the nuts, the candies, and like that. When it leaves our place, it's vanilla or chocolate.
So when you're standing there at the ice cream stand and you're watching everybody enjoy their ice cream, do you sit back and in your head think, this is pretty cool?
No, I think that's more mix we have to make.
That's more mix. Honey, I got to go back to work. But it's got to, again, going back to growing up on the dairy farm and actually getting your hands, you know, and having that hands-on touch to it, to see people enjoying ice cream in the summertime has to be.
Yeah, it is. It's a sense of accomplishment, I suppose you could say. And over the years, I started out at the dairy. I delivered for numerous years, so I know a lot of our customers and stay in contact with them still.
Well, I imagine that work ethic that you gained, you know, from working on the farm, too, has stayed with you all this time, too.
I've tried to get rid of most of it.
Sleeping into, nine.
Yeah, I don't get up early anymore. But,
okay, never mind. I didn't ask that.
No. Well, Deb, you know, when it comes to folks like the Titusville Dairy and what you do with trying to promote Titusville and work with bringing companies into the area and that community outreach, how important is it to have somebody like Titusville Dairy as part of that piece of the puzzle?
It goes back to my first comment that to stay successful, you need to be unique. You need to provide a specific product. It's hard for a small business like this to compete with the larger manufacturer. So having that unique product that they make that's specialized, that is custom made almost sometimes, is important. And mm-hmm. highlighting that and keeping them here and keeping them strong is what we do.
And I'm sure when you're talking with companies and they're saying, well, what else do you have going on? And you point to Titusville Dairy. I mean, that's got to be a nice piece to have.
I just did a meeting on Tuesday. I mentioned that we were going to be on the show, and they're like, what? We never knew that happened there. They have how many employees? Where are they? You know, so it makes me proud to be able to tell people about it. And we're very thankful that they're here.
Yeah, absolutely. Ralph, sounds like great things are happening at the dairy, celebrating 90 years this year. That's incredible. That's incredible. And keep up the good work with what's happening over there.
Well, we're going
to
try.
And, of course, we're getting close to the middle end of February, and a lot of these stands are going to start opening up and selling ice cream in the next, the next month, I think?
Yeah, probably. By the end of March, most of them are open.
So you'll be back into that cycle.
Yep.
Good.
That's incredible. And real quick, just repeat some of those numbers on how much of your product is going out the door.
We manufactured about 3.5 million pounds of cottage cheese last year, about 98,000 pounds of chip dip.
And that's just for this Sunday.
Yeah. 1.4 million gallons of mix, about 760,000 pounds of sour cream. And those are our mainstays. We do a little cream cheese and we do yogurt. I don't know why I missed yogurt. We actually do quite a bit of yogurt. We do flavor that strawberry, raspberry, vanilla, peach, and plain.
Cool. Wow. That's so good to know. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And when you see Deb coming over, you lock the door?
Yeah, my office is right by the refrigerator, so I can't hide.
I look for him every right time there. I go, and then the door goes shut. You won't talk to me.
Yeah, right there in plain sight. Ralph, again, there's such a great history with the dairy. Is there any place folks can go to maybe read more about the history of the dairy?
I actually, David Weber has done the history for me a couple times.
Good.
And I have some copies of that there. And I think we may do something for our 90th year this year and get the word out. He does a fantastic job of putting all the facts together that I don't know where he comes up with them from.
I know. He's wonderful to have him.
Yeah. All right. Another wonderful guest this morning, Ralph Kerr, joining us from the Titusville Dairy Products Company. Thank you so much for coming in. Another great job. And again, keep up the good work. 90 years. A lot to be proud of. I should know. It tastes a lot of ice cream. All right, Deb, good to see you. And we'll see you in 2 weeks. All right, well, listen, in 2 weeks, I'll be here physically, probably not mentally.
This is different.
Thanks very much. We've got the folks from the Crawford County Food Program coming up next.